Hello YouTube. Bane666 here. I would just like to state that it's a strange, strange world.
هذه الأقدام التي تنتعل الكعب العالي ليست لنساء، إنما هي لرجال لبنانيين أرادوا عشية اليوم العالمي للمرأة توجيه رسالة دعم لها.
لأن مرة باحترامها من راسها لكعبة.
واجد الحتة، سماح الحكيم وسمار الحتة جالوا بالكعب العالي في أحد المراكز التجارية، مشهد قابلته الدهشة على وجوه المتسوقين. هم فعلوا ذلك ليقولوا لا للعنف الأسري ولا للتمييز ضد المرأة بأسلوب أرادوه طريفا يسهل إيصال الفكرة. المبادرة بعنوان افشو لذيذ تناقلتها بكثرة مواقع التواصل الاجتماعي.
السياسة بتفرق والدين بفرق والمناطقية بتفرق والطائفية بفرق، كل شيء بفرق إلا الضحك. نحن عارفين أنه هالمبادرة اللي عملناها هذا الفيديو الصغير اللي هو ممكن يكون مضحك ويوصل هذه الرسالة، ما راح يغير الواقع دغري اليوم، مش هلا بس عالم، بس النواب مثلا شافوا هذا الفيديو راح يروحوا اليوم يمضوا قانون حماية المرأة من العنف الأسري، بس هذا بيعطي أمل. فالرسالة إذا بدك للمرأة ضلها تكافح تتوصل.
This seems very similar to the walk a mile in her shoes march. Just in case you do not know what that is, it's where men put on high heels and walk a mile to stop rape, sexual assault and gender violence, but only against women. Because we all know that only bad things happen to women, and these bad things are only ever done by men, right? Yeah, right, just more bigoted bullshit disguised as equality. But do not take my word for it. Let's see what their website has to say. Put yourself in her shoes. Each year, an ever-increasing number of men, women and their families are joining the award-winning Walk a Mile in Her Shoes, the International Men's March to Stop Rape, Sexual Assault and Gender Violence. A Walk a Mile in Her Shoes event is a playful opportunity for men to raise awareness in their community about the serious causes, effects and remediations to men's sexualized violence against women. Strange they do not mention female sex predators and their male victims, you know, like this woman, who will only serve 12 months in jail for raping an 8-year-old boy, repeatedly over a 2-year period. Why is there no woman marching for him? Oh, that's right, because only men do bad things. Let's read on. First, you walk the walk. There is an old saying, you cannot really understand another person's experience until you have walked a mile in their shoes. Walk a Mile in Her Shoes asks men to literally walk 1 mile in women's high-heeled shoes. It's not easy walking in these shoes, but it's fun and it gets the community to talk about something that's really difficult to talk about, gender relations and men's sexual violence against women. Once again, note that this campaign is not about stopping sexual violence, but about stopping sexual violence by men towards women. What about sexual violence in same-sex relationships? Is that acceptable? We never hear about these groups talking about the high number of sexual assaults in lesbian relationships. Do those victims not count? Or is it that they are afraid to acknowledge female sexual predators? They are willing to ignore female victims in order to avoid talking about female perpetrators, it would seem. What about male victims? The only time society wants to talk about them is when they are the victim in a rape joke. The only type of rape joke that seems to be okay, by the way. And what about children, both male and female, who are the victims of both male and female pedophiles? Why focus exclusively on one gender as the victim and one as the victimizer? But let's read on. Then you talk the talk. It's critical to open communication about sexualized violence. While hidden away, sexualized violence is immune to cure. Unfortunately, it's difficult to get people talking. People unfamiliar with men's sexualized violence against women do not even want to know it exists. It's ugly. People that have experienced sexualized violence themselves want to forget about it. How do you get people talking now, so they can prevent it from happening? And if it's already happened, how do you help them get help to recover? Yeah, once again, we have females exclusively as the victims, and males exclusively as the victimizers. But do they acknowledge male victims anywhere? Yes, they do, kind of. Not just a women's issue. Sexualized violence does not just affect women. It affects the men who care about them, their families, their friends, their co-workers, and their communities. Sexualized violence is epidemic. Some of the statistics, every 2 minutes someone in America is raped. 1 in 6 American women are victims of sexual assault. That means someone you know, someone you care about, has been or may become the victim of sexual violence. It may be your mother, your sister, your friend, your girlfriend, your wife, your co-worker, or your daughter. Oh, okay, so the only way a male can be a victim is through a female victim. It's almost like they do not believe males can be actual victims. Let's be fucking clear here, rape and sexual assault affects females, males, and children. Its victims are not gender specific. And the perpetrators can be male or female. Sexual predators are not gender specific. So I thought I would whip up a couple of posters to set the Walk a Mile in Her Shoes campaign straight. But as sexual assault should not be a gendered issue, I wondered if there was an issue that affected mainly males, and would fit the footwear theme better. I came up with this. We'll be right back.